So, as we have already discussed, the global population has distributed in very unequal manner. Some of the areas are densely populated, some are very sparsely populated, some of the areas are having population density of more than 1000 person per square kilometer, like Bangladesh and like in India, West Bengal, even Bihar, Kerala, we have all the regions having population density of more than 1000 person per square kilometer. And even in India we have areas like Ladakh region, Himalayan region, desert region, run of Kutch region, where population is less than 10% per square kilometer, very sparse. So where is 10% to 1000 person and more population distribution? It is basically determined by the carrying capacity of the earth. Carrying capacity in the combination of the level of technology, that is called culture of the society. Some of the areas where carrying capacity is very low but population density is very high, and all people can sustain the high population density. I gave you the example of Netherlands, where population density is higher than the population density of India, and neither they have mineral resources nor they have space to live, and further they capture the land from the sea. What is the process? What do you call the process of land capturing? Poldering. Poldering is the process, and they are not declared as an overpopulated country. Still they are very close to optimum population. So basically it is the level of technology and the availability of natural resources. But in present day world, like we have the state like Gujarat, they don't have mineral resources which are the basic requirement for industries. But Jharkhand have minerals. Jharkhand, they don't have industries. All industries are in Gujarat. They don't have, because they have culture, they have technology, they utilize the advantage. So always, that's why the population density of Jharkhand is less than the population density of Gujarat. So there are so many factors. Overall we used to say carrying capacity of the land, kisi jagah ki zameen ko kitne log wahan zinda reh sakte hain, ye uski kitne logon ko zinda rakh sakti hai wo bhoomi, us sthan ke sansadhan aur us sthan ki technology par nirbhar karta hai, jisko hum carrying capacity kehte hain. ये अर्थ अपने आप में एक शिप है जो स्पेस में चल रहा है, स्पेस शिप, और इस स्पेस शिप में इसकी कैरिंग कैपेसिटी है. जहाँ कैरिंग कैपेसिटी इस शिप की ज़्यादा हो जाएगी, पॉवर्टी आ जाएगी, और जहाँ कैरिंग कैपेसिटी कम रहेगी, ये शिप अच्छे से चलता रहेगा. सो दैट्स व्हाई वी यूज्ड टू डिस्कस. आई गेव यू सो मैनी पैरामीटर्स एंड फैक्टर्स for unequal distribution of technology, unequal distribution of population. Again, I'll repeat. I'm repeating some of the factors which determine the unequal distribution of population. So it is the factors. What are the factors for unequal distribution? Factors for unequal. Unequal distribution of population. Number one, physical factor. In my previous class, I gave you the example of some of the countries like Mongolia and some of the countries like Russia, even USA, Canada, where population density is less than, like USA have more, but Canada and Mongolia and some of the countries, they are having population density less than 3% per square kilometer. But some countries are having more than 1000% per square kilometer. So physical factors are playing vital role. In physical factors, basically relief factors. continentality factor. महाद्वीपों के अंदर की तरफ जाएंगे, if we go to the interior of the continents, population density decreases. So the carrying capacity of earth is more near the coast because we have the trade facilities, we have the fishing facilities, we have the suitability of climate. Sea के किनारे पे जाएंगे, climate suitable होता चला जाएगा. महाद्वीपों के अंदर चले जाएंगे तो climate fluctuating होता जाएगा. So water maintain the homogeneity of climate. ज़्यादा fluctuation समुद्र के किनारे नहीं होती. So more fluctuation and climate takes place when we go to the interior of the continent. So continentality and the climate. Climate is, I discussed the factors, keen factor, scorching factor, muggy factor, or the raw factor, they decide the temperature and humidity both. They decide the, these are basically the physical factors apart from that, soil. Soil is also the soil, fertility of the soil. But apart from soil, only soil fertility is not sufficient. The climate which determine the crop growing seasons. Crop growing seasons. Like, some of the areas are having more than one crop growing season, some are having more than two crop growing seasons, and in rare case some of the areas are having more than three crop growing seasons. Like in eastern India, warm temperature, sufficient moisture, and we can grow more crops, it means we can produce more food, and when more food is there, more people can sustain in that condition. So it is the crop growing season. Like in USA, cold climate, so they take only one crop in a year. They don't have summer season, they have spring season. Basically their summer is like our winter, December is like their summer, so they used to pronounce it as a spring season. So they take one crop, and that is either barley or wheat or potato. Basically these are the common crops. Maize, corn is also very important crop in central and southern USA. But in prairie grassland they take only one crop in a year. So this is the cropping season. And in physical factors, basically it is physical factors which determine the availability of water. Availability of water for survival. Water is the most important factor, and water is the outcome of relief. It is the outcome of continentality. Near relief means when it is the wind facing slope, we have more water. On the leeward slope, we have the less water. Like in India, if I make this is in India, it is the western Ghats. So wind facing slopes of the western part. So if I make it like this, it is like this, and this is asymmetrical. This is steep slope and this is gentle slope. So most of the winds which move inside the Indian strike, this western part, उसपे आते हैं तो they yield rain here, and this is leeward slope. Leeward slope, and this slope is also pronounced as rain shadow area. So water is determined by the relief, not only here but everywhere. So it is the water is determined by the relief conditions. Water is determined by the continentality. Like when the monsoon winds approaches in the country, say. मैंने आपको पिछले सेमेस्टर में बताया था, लाइक कोलकाता 120 सेंटीमीटर एनुअल रेनफॉल. थोड़ा सा अंदर जाइए, पटना में आ जाइए, 105 सेंटीमीटर रेनफॉल, थोड़ा सा अंदर इलाहाबाद आ जाइए 95 सेंटीमीटर रेनफॉल, कानपुर 75, दिल्ली 62 सेंटीमीटर, एंड फर्दर आप बीकानेर में चले जाइए 40 सेंटीमीटर. एज वी गो टू द इंटीरियर ऑफ द कॉन्टिनेंट अमाउंट ऑफ रेन रेनफॉल डिक्रीजेस. If when we construct the equal lines showing the equal rainfall, what you call those lines? So this is basically, it is like this, lines of equal rainfall, they are known as
isoheights.
So these are the isoheights. When we when we go to the interior of the continent, the amount of rainfall decreases, so the carrying capacity of the supply of water decreases. I said availability of water is determined by the continentality, by the climate. Climate is, whether if it is the monsoonal climate, we receive 90% rainfall in 3 months in a year, and 10% rainfall takes place in rest of the 9 months in a year. So very unequal distribution of rainfall. If we have the Mediterranean climate, we receive 80% rain during winter season. Only during summer we receive only 20% rain. But like if we say British type of climate, we receive almost equitable rainfall round the year, but more rain during winter. So and like in equatorial climate, we receive rain almost round the year, every day. In equatorial region, every day in the morning till noon and till afternoon, evaporation takes place, and in the evening 4 to 6 p.m. there is the condensation and rainfall takes place. Pura saal, har roz din mein, if we go to equatorial region, say Singapore, every day there is the rainfall in the evening at Singapore. So there is the rain round the year, there is the rain for most part of the year, there is the rain for few days in a year. Like in deserts we have no rain. Like in Delhi we have 40 to 45 rainy days in a year. But when we, if we see the Guwahati and Shillong and Dhaka and Kolkata, we have 70 to 75 rainy days in a year. But when we go to Jaisalmer, we have 10 to 12 rainy days in a year. So number of rainy days are decreasing. So the availability of water is determined by the relief, by the continent, and by the climate. Climate is very important, significant factor, and water decide. Water, and not only water, the permeability of water. Water is attached with so many parameters to determine the carrying capacity of the people. पानी का हम बजट क्या है? बजट मींस व्हाट इज द रेगुलरिटी, साल भर कितना पानी आता है, उसको कैसे यूज कर सकते हैं. इफ वी मेक द बजटिंग, इफ वी हैव द कंप्लीट डेटा ऑफ वाटर, देन ओनली वी कैन यूज द वाटर. वो वाटर जमीन में, इफ द लैंड इज पोरस, इट इज स्टोर्ड इन द सब सोयल. सब सोयल में वाटर है तो कैरिंग कैपेसिटी वहां की बढ़ जाती है. द ग्रीन रेवोल्यूशन इन नॉर्थ इंडिया is possible because ground water is there. In peninsular plateau, subsoil is barren rock, hard basalt, igneous rocks, impermeable rocks, recharge is not taking place. So they don't have the ground water in central India and peninsular India, where everywhere we in the plateau part of India, we don't have the ground water. Rocks are not rechargeable, impermeable rocks are there. So the water is basically, and the nature of slope, like in Himalayas, Himalayan system is known as the water tower of the world. It supply water, maximum water comes from this area, or hundreds of rivers, Ganga and its tributaries, and Kosi and Gandak and Bagmati and the Yamuna and the Brahmaputra and the hundreds, thousands of rivers they are draining. Indus, so entire South Indian subcontinent, not only South Indian, even East Asian, Myanmar. So the Chindwin River and Salwin River obtain water from Himalayan system. So this is, but still Himalayan system, they don't have water in Himalayas. Himalaya is water deficit region. The main reason for out migrating from the Himalayan region, the people are coming down from the highland to lowland, it is because they don't have water. Because it is this slopy area, immediately water discharge to the down in the area, in the lower area. So in the slopes, generally immediately washed away the water. So the nature of slope relief, permeability, the water harvesting, these are the factors which determine the water. So in Haryana, they don't have any river, but they have some canals from perennial rivers. But canals are not sufficient to supply water for irrigation in Haryana, so they have the groundwater. Every farmer is having their own tube well because groundwater is there. It is not in Maharashtra, it is not in Karnataka. The groundwater is not in in Tamil Nadu, so because they have the hard rocks. So the availability of water is very important parameter near the river valleys, like Nile River Valley. 95% of the population of Egypt, जिसको हम मिस्र कहते हैं, इजिप्ट की 95% population lives in 20 किलोमीटर east and 20 किलोमीटर west of the Nile River, in a stretch parallel to the, in a 40 किलोमीटर trend of Nile River. Nile River के 20 किलोमीटर इधर, you must be knowing, so this is the Nile. So this 20 kilometer band, 40 kilometer band, so 98 itna bada desh hai. Is desh mein keval is belt mein 95% log rehte hain. That constitute only 5% of the total geographical area of Egypt. Only 5% of the geographical area of Egypt is having more than 90% population lives. It is because of the water. Even in, you can say in China, the deltaic region of Huang Ho, the Yangtze Basin, the Zi River, so they are most densely populated part of China. Even in Southeast Asia, Chindwin River, Salwin River, Chao Phraya River, Menam River, jisko Menam kehte hain, Chao Phraya. Chao Phraya is the lifeline of Laos and all three countries. And the Mekong River, Mekong is the one of the longest river in Southeast Asia. So Mena, Mekong, Chao, Irrawaddy, Chao Phraya, Salwin, Chindwin, Ji, Zin, Yangtze River, Sikyang River, and Huang Ho River. All these rivers near the river valleys, they are having the high population density. As we go away from the river, we don't find the density. So irregular, wherever the water is there, wherever the river valley is there, we have the high population density. Like in USA, the delta of Mississippi River, in Louisiana, in Georgia, there are the cities like Augusta, Atlanta, and these are the densely populated cities, Montgomery. So because they have the agricultural conditions are ideal, they are having high population density in the deltaic region. Even in Niger River, where in Nigeria, Lagos, Port Harcourt, these are the cities where high population density is there because of the availability of water. And all over the world, wherever the water is available, we have the high population density. Or most of the cities are developed either on the coast or they are located on the bank, on the margin of a river. If river is not there, cities are not growing. So a few cities, I don't think having any million cities located without river. So all they require water, regular water supply. Like in India we have. India is quite exceptional. Jaipur is one of them. It's a million city without water. Jodhpur is also a million city without water. So the cities are, even Ajmer is also a million city. But it is, they have the source of water. Intermountain lake is there. So basically the availability of water determined. Sometimes we can harvest water, sometimes we cannot harvest water. Sometimes we can use the water for irrigation by the construction of canal or by controlling the water, by diverting the water through the embankments and the dams, by the channels we can shift the water, sometimes we cannot shift the water. In a peninsular plateau we cannot shift the water. Peninsular plateau receive 4 times more water than North India. But most part of India, drought prone part of India lies in peninsular plateau. And that receive 4 times more water than North India. It is because we cannot shift water in South India. They don't have subsoil water. And that we cannot construct canal because land is undulated. It is hard, it is difficult. So the government of India is having a dream plan to connect the rivers. Connecting the river is a big plan. It's very soothing to listen, but it's not easy to make it a practical. In 1973, there was a Dastur plan. Dastur was the architect, the topmost architect of India based at London, Kolkata, presented a plan to Mrs. Indira Gandhi in 1973. India was passing through under the process, the vagaries of poverty, energy crisis, food crisis, everything, all problems were there. And the war crisis, refugee crisis from Bangladesh and all. And Dastur submitted a plan, Ganga Kaveri plan. He said we can shift the water of Ganga to Kaveri through the peninsular plateau. Further, he submitted another plan, Garland Canal. Garland Canal plan means to connect both the coasts. This and this water should be shifted. The water of Ganga to be shifted here, Narmada to be shifted here. It's a garland, mala ki tarah. Aise nadiyan bana de. In nadiyon ko connect kar de, iska pani isme aur isme ultimately kahan jayega ye pani? Yahan ke jahan drought hai, wahan shift kare. So water of the flood prone area may be shifted to the drought prone area. So that was Dastur plan. But when Mrs. Indira Gandhi asked the finance involved in the plan, वो इतना बड़ा फाइनेंस था कि इंडिया की उस टाइम की 5 ईयर प्लान को भी जोड़ दे तो भी उसमें पैसा पूरा नहीं होता था. मिसेज इंदिरा गांधी टुक द फाइल एंड पुट इन द रेड टेप एंड द टेप इज नॉट येट ओपन. आफ्टर दैट वाजपेयी गवर्नमेंट ट्राइड टू हैव ए डिफरेंट अप्रोच टू स्टार्ट द प्लान टू प्रोवाइड द वाटर फ्रॉम वाटर सरप्लस एरिया टू वाटर डेफिसिट एरिया थ्रू कनेक्टिंग एट माइक्रो लेवल. छोटे छोटे रिवर्स को कनेक्ट करो. ओके, गंगा को कावेरी से तो एकदम नहीं जोड़ सकते, इतना बड़ा प्लान मत बनाओ. कनेक्ट स्मॉल रिवर्स, सरप्लस टू डेफिसिट, सरप्लस टू डेफिसिट. जिस नदी में ज्यादा पानी आ गया है उसको, जिसमें कम पानी है उधर शिफ्ट करो. सो वी आर इन द प्रोसेस इन मध्य प्रदेश, वी आर इन द प्रोसेस बेतवा और केन को हमने जोड़ा है. पार्वती को केन से भी जोड़ने की प्लान है इन पन्ना. एंड आई मे नॉट रिकॉल द नेम ऑफ द रिवर्स एग्जैक्टली एंड द लोकेशन, बट वी आर कनेक्टिंग स्मॉल रिवर्स सो वी कैन शिफ्ट द सरप्लस वाटर टू द डेफिसिट वाटर. इन मध्य प्रदेश लाइक द नेट सोन एरिया हैज इंक्रीज ट्रिमेंडसली इन लास्ट 20 ईयर्स बिकॉज ऑफ द वाटर हार्वेस्टिंग. Simultaneously, the crop production has increased manifold only because of the water harvesting. So, water is the most important parameter for the human habitation and the increase with deciding the population distribution on the earth surface. So, highland area we have less water, lowland area we have the more water. So, and water determine the crops, water determine the human sustainability. So, for every purpose we need water. So, we are most 99% of the human habitations are wet point habitations, wet point settlement. So it is basically water is the important factor. Apart from that, some other human factors. These are the physical factors. So in human factors, basically I would say urbanization is one of the factors. Urbanization, wherever the people shifted from rural areas to urban areas for the better livelihood, urban areas become population islands, and these population islands become pollution islands. These pollution islands become problem islands, and in geography we used to pronounce them as heat islands. The heat islands, urban centers are pronounced as heat islands. These are the population islands. So the population density of Delhi, you know, it is more than 12,000 person per square kilometer. The population density of entire national capital region, average population density is 550. But the population density of Delhi is more than 12,000. But if we take the only urban areas, it is more than 25,000. If we take the slum area, population density is more than 1 lakh person per square kilometer. So this density, urban areas are the having the high population density. And most of the urban centers, there are the two type of urban centers. One is the primate urban centers and one is the rank size urban centers. In developed world, we have the rank size rule. Urbanization is equally distributed. But in India, a kind of country where third world countries, where urbanization was developed by the colonial powers for a certain purpose at certain areas, we have the primate cities. And primate cities means they provide every one urban center provide every facility to its entire hinterland. So most population get accumulated in urban areas, so that those urban areas become high population island, heat island, problem island, pollution island. So the urban areas, they provide employment round the year. Rural areas, we don't have employment round the year. Agriculture have fluctuating employment. In agricultural sector, they have, like if I graphically, if I construct the employment condition, of say around the year in the month of January, February, March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November and December. And this is the working hours. Say 5, 10 and 15. Ek din mein 5 ghante kaam karta hai, 10 ghante, 15 ghante. Indian farmer in the month of January kya karta hai? Kuch nahi karta. Bilkul. Say take example of Haryana farmer or UP farmer, Punjab farmer. जनवरी में कुछ नहीं होता और फरवरी में बिल्कुल ही काम नहीं होता, एक घंटे भी नहीं करते. मार्च में हार्वेस्टिंग आती है और इतना इतना 15 घंटे काम करता और अप्रैल में फिर खाली बैठ जाता. देन फिर वो पूरे मई जून जुलाई अगस्त तक बारिश नहीं आती, पानी नहीं है तो क्या काम करेगा. जुलाई आती है फिर वो कुछ काम करता है हार्वेस्टिंग, फिर खाली बैठ जाता है. फिर सेप्टेम्बर अक्टूबर में फिर